Lakshadweep is in crisis and the people there need you. You can begin by searching hashtag Save Lakshadweep on Instagram and you'll see that there are barely 1,000 plus posts, majority from Kerala. You can also do the same search on Google and you'll see that most media houses has reported on what Prithviraj has tweeted on the issue than on the issue itself. Hats off to everyone who has responded. But please remember that Lakshadweep is not Kerala's Union Territory, but India's Union Territory. Every person from every nook and corner of the country has to respond. Remember that if you don't respond today, they will come for you tomorrow, just like they've come for everybody else. I'm going to make this as short as possible, so please listen. Lakshadweep is a group of islands found in the Arabian Sea with approximate population of 70,000 people. The past administrators of Lakshadweep were all civil servants, but right now we have Modi's Praful Patel as the administrator. The draft Lakshadweep Development Authority Regulation Act of 2021 gives unchecked powers to the administration in order to encroach through land ownership and usage in the name of development. Let's consider some of the draconian measures issued by the administration in Lakshadweep. Initially, Lakshadweep had zero COVID cases. That is because of the excellent quarantine procedure. You basically had to quarantine yourself 7 days in Kochi, take an RT-PCR test. If that's negative, you come to Lakshadweep and there is a 14-day quarantine period there as well. But ever since the arrival of Praful Patel, you only require a COVID negative certificate, an RT-PCR test, in order to enter Lakshadweep. Right now, Lakshadweep has 6,600 COVID cases with approximately 24 deaths. The Animal Preservation Act has been used to ban cattle slaughter in a predominantly Muslim populated island and also to remove non-veg from school menus. All dairy farms in Lakshadweep has been ordered to be closed down and Gujarat-based Amul milk products are going to be forced upon the people. The Gunda Act, which allows the government to arrest a person without trial and imprison him or her for a year, is also going to be enacted. History shows that this has been used to arrest people for political dissent. Earlier, police were also asked to arrest people who had erected anti-CAA NRC boards. Can you imagine introducing a draft law to remove panchayat members who has more than two kids, dismissing contact laborers, casual laborers who have been appointed by the government, dismissing physical education teachers and midday meal workers, closing down 38 Anganwadis, stopping freight transit through the Baipur ports in order to cut traditional ties with Kerala. Using the Coast Guard Act, temporary sheds created by fishermen to store their equipments and nets are being demolished, and this is in a place where the major source of income is fishing. Then there is also restrictions on selling alcohol being lifted, instructions in order to widen the roads in a place where there are not many vehicles, there's not much traffic, and houses and buildings that will come in the way will also be demolished. Reports that youth workers who were employed as marine watchers, whose job was to ensure that commercial sand mining and sea cucumber harvesting does not take place, their work is being blocked by the administration. The Kerala Student Unions and the NSUI's Twitter account has been suspended for speaking about this issue. There is also critical posts are being censored on social media and internet blackout looms large. Praful Patel is the administrator of Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, where there is an FIR registered against him under the SCPOA Act for the abetment of suicide of the Adivasi leader and 7-time MP Mohan Delkar. You have to understand that this is an undemocratic anti-people Hindutva project that has to be resisted.
Smart city
These decisions have been taken against the will of the people. What is happening in Lakshadweep is settler colonialism, where the government is trying to replace the indigenous people with corporates and Hindutva. If we do not act now, we will have another Palestine or Kashmir. The BJP government is trying to inject its fascist colonial ideologies and administration on the people of Lakshadweep. You can even see some BJP and RSS workers who are blaming ISIS terrorists and Islamists for pushing back against this corporate project. Please don't keep quiet. Please keep creating more posts, use the hashtag #SaveLakshadweep. The more noise we make, the more attention we could grab. There's also a Twitter storm taking place from 4 to 9. Please take part in it if you could. Tag the celebrities and media houses who have not responded on this issue. Share this video or any other resources that would help people understand the grave nature of this issue. Also understand that there are not many resources available in English, so please create more of them. Please keep sharing. It is the least you could do. The people of Lakshadweep are not able to do much. We could be their voices. And remember that the government is here to serve us and not rule us. Never rule us. Let's change the world, one thought at a time.